Okay. We're going to try the two-lap 60-mile race by TWA. Should take me about 18 minutes. No. Well, maybe. Nine and a half. Nine is 18, 19 minutes. I don't know, we'll see. The first lap is. I do my regular cheats. I think it just runs more smoother and I can concentrate on the road instead of figuring out where the hell I'm supposed to turn. Here we go. Slow, go slow, get wrapped up in the trees. Now I can haul ass after this next curve. Now, all the way up the hill. Right here. I stayed on the road this time. And I don't do the... Like right here is where you go down in the grass. Right about there. I just follow the road. Nobody behind me. I go all the way down to the freeway. Go. That was perfect. See how far they are behind me when I get down to here. The thing of it is, I just like to hit this. I mean, if you could hit it in 3 minutes and 20 seconds or 3:18, that's perfect. If you're hitting it at 3:40 or 4 or whatever. I don't know what time you get. Tell me what time you get when you hit this. See? 3:18. Sometimes I get 3:20 if I do a slip and run into a tree or something. I want to know what you get at that point. That's like the halfway point right there. The rest of this ought to be a piece of cake. Well, this part is anyway. Because we know where to turn and not crash. And we don't have to go over the jump anymore, so that's all good. No jumps and crashing there. You have to just slow down when you get to it. Coming up on it now, so slow down, hit the brakes, turn, gas. This is easy, you know you're going to go left, then right. Then brake. Then right, left. and then left, right. Go down halfway, hit the brakes. Right about here is where you want to do it. And this is where I just go straight, and I always will. It's perfect. I'm going to go straight here. This is where I kind of get lost, and I have to look at the map all the time to see where I am. After I get on this, it's pretty easy. Just follow the yellow brick road. Or the blue-green trail, whatever. This is where I'm the most careful. You can see, I even put on brakes. I go so slow, it's like 80 miles an hour. So you crash there, man, that's it, you're done. Even around here, I'm careful until I get onto the main road, which is right about here. Then I can just do my regular thing I'm used to doing. Not paying attention to where they are, but I'll check. About now. Say they're a little bit behind me. If you got an inch or two, what I call an inch or two, and they're not right on your ass, then you should be pretty good. If they're on your ass, then you're in trouble. Plus, we got a squiggly over here that'll give me more room. At the end of this, there's a squiggle. I don't try to go full blast here either. Now I do. Up here and hit the brakes so you don't go off the road. This again. Should have a pretty good lead, but when I check it, you'll see it's about the same kind of a gap. It's because I have to hit the brakes there and here. Probably why. Well, it's a little bigger gap. Then there's another squiggly at the end that gives me even a bigger gap. So when I go into lap two, I won't have to worry about anything, which I don't have to worry about anything right now. But when I was doing my race, I ended up in third place on the second lap, so that sucked. Plus on my race, I was a minute slower. So, I don't need to do my race anymore, just do yours. I've been playing so much lately that this is all natural to me, just doing all this part. Know when to hit the brakes, know when to accelerate, know when to turn. Know when to let off the gas, coast. But sometimes I wake up and I still, my brain's so fried that I can't even think. And I start to make mistakes like that, see? Now I can't get through it. What the hell? Come on. There we go. Now that was a big fuck up there. And I bet you $1 million I still beat 10 minutes. Sometimes I crash right in here because I'm looking at the time to see what I did on the first lap. So we'll call that a normal lap because A, it wasn't a record, and B, I only crashed once, so that's pretty much normal for me to crash once. Not if I do a horrific crash. That would really take some time. I'm not going to be as careful on the second lap. And that's what happens. God damn it. Oh, I'm supposed to go here anyway. That was called half of the crash. Show you what a real crash looks like. Oh, Jesus. That's a real crash. I'll never make up for that one. Come on, turn. I could get it to turn the right way. Jesus frickin' Christ. I don't want to hit that thing, that's for sure. There we go. So let's say you crashed a bunch of times, like I just did. You'll probably get a 340 or something like that, instead of a 320, maybe even a 350. I don't know what it's going to be. $320, $319, $318, that's the standard. No crashes. And we get a $332, which is about 12 seconds behind the standard. I'm still in front with crashes. So it doesn't really affect anything other than my time. And I might get less on the levels because I didn't stay on the blue-green line. Oh, I took out everything. Damn it. Wow. Look at that. And I'm done. That was a good one. This is the difference between a good lap and a bad lap. Guy's on my ass. Here's the story. See that? When they're all on your ass? Some stragglers back there. There's some there. Oh, some there. But they're a whole bunch right on my ass right now. A couple. Don't watch me, I'll get rid of them. Still being first. There they go. If we get a 1-inch gap, I'm good. Still gonna break 9. Or 10. Differences on the first lap. You're not going back and forth on the freeway, you're not doing anything extra. So, you don't have to worry about going back and forth 4 times or doing town straights 2 times. Just run it. Now, if I ran the regular 4 laps this way, I probably wouldn't get as many points. I just forgot about the extra stuff that we do just to get extra credits. You don't need them. I still kind of do. So I'm trying to get to the next level, which I need like 850. I'm on 230 or something like that. So I got another 600 plus levels to go. See, they'll disappear on this right there. I have to do the squigglies. See how many minutes it takes them to get to me. Probably another minute. I got a 9:39. Which I screwed around for about 20 seconds or so, so I would probably get a 9. I'd break 9:30. Let's put it that way if I didn't crash. I'm just gonna wait and see the next one. It says their best lap was 10 something. So I'm still 20 seconds ahead. There they are. Okay, so 19:34 and they did it 20. So that's 30 seconds. About 30 seconds behind. They still got a 30 second gap to do more crashes. Alright, let's see if I get two levels out of this. What's right there? One. Two. Two and a half. Got 2.5 levels out of it. Collect my measly prize of 5,000. What's the lowest? 2? Yeah, I like it. Okay, we're done.